As a judge who sits currently on the Allegheny County Court of Common Pleas in the criminal division, I know all too well the problems associated with the use of cash bail, particularly in circumstances where it is being used and is turns out to be punitive for nonviolent offenders and those that simply cannot pay. It is unacceptable in our society to utilize pretrial incarceration before someone has been proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt and have them sit in a jail cell awaiting trial simply because they are poor or cannot pay. It is critical that we understand that the only things that should be keeping people in jail pretrial are when they pose a danger to a specific individual or to the community at large, or there are circumstances that show that you simply will not be able to get them to trial. Otherwise, we should not be using cash bail. We should be using non-monetary conditions of bond. If somebody has a substance abuse issue, if somebody has mental health issues, there are things that we can put in place with respect to a bond that will assist them pre-trial and that will not put them in a 6x8 jail cell where they do not belong, particularly before they've been convicted of any crime. As courts, we have to figure this out and do it quickly. Our courts have a real responsibility to utilize restorative justice in diversionary courts, to take our nonviolent offenders who fall into specific categories and place them in opportunities where they are in the best position to succeed. One of the issues with diversionary courts is making sure that individuals that suffer from particular kinds of issues, whether it's substance abuse in our drug courts, whether it is mental health issues in our mental health treatment courts, whether it's veterans court, we have to be very mindful of the fact that these individuals often need second chances and they need treatment, not convictions. So one of the things that I would like to see happen in our courts is a focus on getting away from convicting individuals of felonies or misdemeanors when we are in our restorative courts or our diversionary courts. We do it with certain types of offenses, but we ought to be looking at doing it particularly with felony offenses because the stigma of a conviction can have such a debilitating effect on somebody's ability to get better and get a job and all the other things that come along with that. So it's really critical for us to look at diversionary courts not just from the diversion perspective, but from the lack of a conviction.
Hi, I'm Dean Birdie, running for Judge, Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. The question that was put to us about bail, my feelings and opinions are that in my 33 years of practicing, I have done many bail reduction hearings. And it's an important part of our judicial process. The judges must consider the health and safety of the community. And in this time of the pandemic, they must also consider the health and safety of the people who are being held for trial. It is an important part of the judicial process to consider all of these things when factoring the amount of bail that will be set.
In my 33 years of practice, I have been involved with several different special courts that have been very successful in helping people get through the challenges that they're facing as they're entering the judicial system. These courts include DUI courts, mental health courts, juvenile drug courts, veterans courts of the Allegheny County, which serve its citizens well. These courts enable people who are in legal crisis to not only deal with the consequences of their actions, but do it in a way that helps them return to be strong members of our society. These courts have great value to our citizens, and when used efficiently, can save taxpayers money and help restore people to positive, beneficial members of society.
Hi, I'm Pauline Calabrese. That's Calabrese for Common Pleas. In response to the first question of my position on the application of cash bail, You know, the United States Constitution says that every individual is presumed innocent until proven guilty. I think that the application of cash bail is fundamentally at odds with the United States Constitution. And frankly, in my experience, every one of my clients have always shown up. I think it's the exception rather than the rule that people do not show up for their court hearings. And obviously, it disproportionately affects the poor. If you have the money, you will show up. Otherwise, we have people who are sitting in the Allegheny County Jail who have not even been found guilty of a crime yet. As for the second question, my position on restorative justice, it always brings me to the, you know, if you ever wondered who would play you in a movie, one of my cases was actually turned into a movie. The movie Losing Isaiah, starring Halle Berry, Jessica Lange, and Samuel L. Jackson. And you guessed it, I was portrayed by Samuel L. Jackson. I was hoping for Halle Berry. But seriously, that was a composite of what was happening in the 1990s. Back in the early 90s, I was fresh out of law school and I was court appointed to represent the mom in the famous Baby Byron case. Back then, the media portrayed drug-addicted moms as monsters. But the truth is, they were really just like the girl next door. They were kind, they were sensitive, they were funny. They were also ashamed and they were trapped in addiction. My experience as being a court-appointed attorney for moms in those positions is that restorative justice is really important. We need to treat drug addiction as a psychological and medical condition to be treated and not a moral failure to be punished. The bottom line is the entire criminal justice system needs to be reformed. In addition, this system is disproportionately affecting minorities. I am the candidate who is ready, willing, and able to help with this reform. As the mayor of Penn Hills, I am the mayor of the highest minority population outside the city of Pittsburgh. I was an adjunct professor for over 10 years at Carleton University, where I taught employment discrimination law, and I have just been endorsed by the Western Pennsylvania Black Political Assembly.
My name is Judge Tom Caulfield, and I am running for a seat on the Court of Common Pleas. I served as a public defender for 19 years before taking the bench, and have been a magisterial district judge since 2010. The issue of criminal justice reform is not some election year discovery for me, but rather has been the center of my career for almost 30 years. Whenever a person is arrested and charged with a crime, bail is set. This is most often done by a magisterial district judge like me. The ACLU conducted a study of cash bail and cited me as the judge who uses it the least. I choose not to use cash bail because it punishes poor people who have yet to be convicted of any crime and falls disproportionately on black men and women. When people cannot pay their bail, they may lose their jobs, their housing, or even custody of their children. All the while, cash bail has not been shown to make our communities any safer and does not meaningfully affect future court attendance. As to the issue of restorative justice and sentencing decisions as an alternative to incarceration, as a magisterial district judge, I already use it in my courtroom and would continue to do so if elected to the Court of Common Pleas. I have found that the practice of restorative justice gives both the accused and the person harmed some ownership of the process. If both sides agree, they can communicate and choose how the case can be resolved to both parties' satisfaction. A mediator may be necessary, but by making them active in the outcome, both parties are empowered, and the results are usually more satisfying than any decision I can impose from the outside. The restorative justice model works especially well with students. I serve in the Woodland Hills School District, and rather than starting children along the school-to-prison pipeline, I have been collaborating for years with the district to divert kids and keep them out of the system altogether. In those instances when charges are filed in my court, I get the student and their family involved in the solution. This can include counseling or therapy as appropriate, community service, and reconciliation with the aggrieved party. Charges may be reduced or withdrawn upon satisfying the agreement. I believe that specialty courts are a part of the reform that must occur, but they should be expanded in a way that makes treatment available for defendants without the necessity of a guilty plea or a conviction. Help for mental health or substance use issues can be uncoupled from the threat of punishment. In fact, I am currently working with my communities to begin a pilot program that would allow certain low-level offenders to be diverted into intensive treatment for their issues rather than being arrested over and over and over again. Creative solutions are all around us if we just look for them. I would like to thank the League of Women Voters of Greater Pittsburgh for the opportunity to discuss these important issues. Thank you.
My name is William Bill Kaye, C-A-Y-E. I'm running for judge of the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. I'm on the Democratic ballot at number 21. I'm on the Republican ballot at number 16. The application of cash bail under our jurisprudence in Pennsylvania is a constitutional prerequisite. It is to be decided by magistrate judges and Court of Common Pleas judges on a case-by-case basis. Cash bail serves a function to assure an individual's appearance in court. However, there are many instances where cash bail would not be applicable if the situation merited other consideration. There are other conditions of pretrial release that are recognized under our rules of criminal procedure. And as a sitting judge, I would apply the most applicable aspect of bail, which could be non-monetary conditions. It could be on your own recognizance. It could be simply some type of a condition like house monitoring or a treatment program. So again, cash bail under our law is an option for the judge at the magisterial level and at the Court of Common Pleas level to visit on a case-by-case basis. The application of restorative sentencing options has always been within the discretion of the trial and sentencing court under our law in Pennsylvania. And the rules of criminal procedure for sentencing purposes, as well as our judicial code for sentencing, allows judges in certain instances where there are nonviolent offenders to look to impose periods of probation or non-incarcerated situations. I can think of cases where if I were elected judge and the right opportunity presented itself, I would ask that individuals that have been convicted be sentenced not necessarily to excessive fines and court costs or probation, but to perhaps provide an affirmative service to their community, to provide an opportunity for an offender to get an educational certification or some specialized trade training with the vocations or the building trades. I would want to get those people to be restored back to productivity and to treat any underlying issues that would be the purpose of sentencing under our restorative justice and our balanced model for a fair and equitable citizenry each time without exception.
I believe that cash bail creates and maintains a two-tiered system whereby those with financial means can get out of jail, while those without financial means are forced to languish for the same offenses, often causing individuals to lose housing and/or employment and making their reintegration into society more difficult, ultimately setting them up for failure. Too often, folks will serve more time incarcerated pretrial than they would ever receive as a sentence if convicted, and most egregious are the cases of low-level, nonviolent offenses in which a fine or a short term of probation will be the ultimate sentence. While magisterial district judges are on the front lines of changing this system, Court of Common Pleas judges need to do their part, and to that end, I am proposing automatic bail review hearings. These hearings would take place within 1 week of an individual's preliminary hearing and would ensure that bad preliminary bail decisions still being made across the county are corrected as soon as possible. Because Court of Common Pleas judges do not have jurisdiction over bail until after an individual's preliminary hearing, the current system often takes 30 to 45 days to correct unfair preliminary bail decisions. Automatic bail review hearings would ensure that these harmful decisions would be remedied within 1 week or less. I believe that diversionary court programs should be the default means of interaction with the criminal justice system. These programs are in the restorative justice mold and allow for individuals to complete their case through a mix of community service, restitution, good behavior, and counseling or treatment where necessary. Oftentimes, folks are able to complete their case without establishing a criminal record and without spending time in jail. Statistics show that these programs improve recidivism rates and reoffense rates, lower overall rates of incarceration, and otherwise benefit both the participants and the burden placed upon the system generally. Currently, we have several successful diversionary court programs, among them Mental Health Court, Drug Court, Veterans Court, Phoenix Court, and ARD. While these programs are positive and effective, we need to go further. I would propose that more program courts be added and that the admissions criteria for all of these courts be made more inclusive. Again, these types of courts should serve as the default means of interaction with the system. These program courts should also be improved to more specifically address the particular situations of participants instead of the current system that deals in one-size-fits-all solutions. Finally, we should work to eliminate the financial barriers and problems associated with the courts as they currently exist.
Hello, my name is Alyssa Cowan, and I'm running for judge of the Court of Common Pleas. Thank you for this opportunity to introduce myself to you. And in terms of the questions posed as to cash bail, there's no question that our current cash bail system disproportionately impacts low-income communities and communities of color and contributes to the structural racism that exists not only in our court system, but in our society at large. Judges have a lot of discretion over when to impose cash bail. And as a judge, I would certainly use that discretion to utilize cash bail for only the most serious offenses when it is absolutely necessary to protect the public or when it's necessary to ensure that a defendant shows up for their next court hearing. In jurisdictions where cash bail has been eliminated, they have seen good success in terms of ensuring that defendants do show up for their next court dates. So I think we can make those efforts here in Allegheny County to certainly reduce our over-reliance on cash bail and work towards a system of eliminating it entirely. In regard to diversionary courts, as a judge, I would certainly utilize diversionary courts as much as I possibly could for as many cases as I could. In Allegheny County, we're fortunate to have several diversionary courts, including mental health court, drug court, sex offender court. And as an attorney who came to the law through social work, I was a practicing social worker first and have my master's degree in social work. I'm working to get individuals connected with the services that address the root causes of them coming into the court system is a huge priority for me. And I've seen clients work through mental health court and have good success with the ability to participate in that process that keeps them in their communities, keeps them in their housing, keeps them connected to their outpatient mental health services and out of incarceration, keeps them in their communities instead of being incarcerated, and how that really does lead to more success with them being able to address any issues that led to their criminal case to begin with. So I would certainly utilize those courts as much as possible. And I would also use those courts as good examples for how we can build out further courts in the future. So thank you for this time today. I appreciate working with all of you on achieving these goals and hope to obtain your vote at the primary on May 18th.
Hello, I'm Rosemary Crawford. I'm running for judge, Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. I'm running because in my 31 years as an attorney who graduated from Georgetown Law School, I've seen a lot of injustice. I believe that I can make a real difference in our county. A question is regarding my position on cash bail. I believe that we need alternatives to cash bail. I do not believe that a person should be in jail simply because they don't have money to pay for bail. In terms of flight risk, I believe in working with community organizations to deal with issues that might cause someone to be a flight risk, such as a housing insecurity, a food insecurity, English as a second language, or if treatment is needed. I think this is very important. During my time as Director of Legal Resources at the YWCA Greater Pittsburgh, I started a program to provide free lawyers for people in need. I would use my program experience and my extensive ties to the community as an award-winning attorney in order to work with different people in our community to find alternatives to cash bail. The next question that was asked was regarding my position on judicial reform and restorative justice. I do believe that those things are necessary. I believe that we need alternatives to incarceration. Diversionary programs for first-time offenders are something that we definitely need, and they need to be extended. Right now, it's limited in our county, and oftentimes people still have a criminal record. We need productive citizens. There needs to be major improvements and extension on diversionary programs. Also, I do believe in treatment over incarceration. I do believe in working with community organizations and people to help with healing of victims and ex-offenders. I would like to see pro se courts, something where people who cannot afford an attorney are able to go before a judge in certain situations and have their cases heard. I'd also like easy to complete forms on the Allegheny County website for those individuals. I'd also advocate for virtual hearings in some situations so that they could be by Zoom, telephone, Skype, or any other alternative program where there is a status involved or some minor form of court. I believe that these are things that would help people who have jobs, who cannot afford parking, who do not have money for bus passes or child care. We need to have judges as servant leaders, people who understand the community and want to make a difference. I'm Rosemary Crawford. I'm running for judge. Thank you.
Our cash bail system has some problems, and the biggest problem is that what we're really doing a lot of times is incarcerating people based on their ability to pay, and for no other reason. These people have not had a finding of guilt. They're simply sitting in jail. They lose everything. They lose their jobs. They lose their homes. Now, a lot of people have suggested simply eliminating cash bail. I think that's going a bit too far, simply because if you consider, for example, a domestic violence situation, somebody can be arrested. These are misdemeanor charges. They would be given not having to pay a dime to get out. And it's been my experience, I've had 30 years in criminal defense practice, that under circumstances like that, they don't care about any no contact order. They are still drunk, they are still high, they are still angry. They go back, they cause more problems for the victim. At some point, public safety has to come into the mix. So while the cash bail system is not perfect, I think we need to really take a close look and how we can improve that while still maintaining public safety and still finding meaningful alternatives to incarceration. I am greatly in favor of restorative justice programs as well as special courts and diversionary dispositions. We have a number of courts here in Allegheny County that are geared toward that type of thing. We have, for example, Veterans Court, Mental Health Court, Sex Offenders Court, Drug Court, DUI Court, things like that. That really can help people get through the system and get back on a positive path. I think that those have worked fantastically. You see such a drop in recidivism. As far as restorative justice is concerned, we typically find that in the juvenile system. The theory is that young people are more, I guess, amenable to righting the wrongs and getting an appreciation for what they've done and being a positive member of society, turning it around. I also think that would work in the adult criminal division, where it's viewed with a mature outlook on life. There are people that are career criminals that don't want to be criminals anymore. And I think that type of system can really give them the push, give them the self-worth, as well as benefit society, and they can get back on this positive path and don't have to worry about criminal court in the future.
Hi, I'm Anthony DeLuca, and I am a candidate for judge of the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. The question posed to me is my opinions on cash bail here in Pennsylvania. I've been involved in the criminal justice system for 23 years, and I've seen how the system operates and how cash bail operates. What I will say to you, and not a lot of people know this, is the pretrial services here in Allegheny County always does a assessment on what bond should be, and it has been years since they have recommended a cash bail. As a result, as long as judges follow those recommendations, cash bail won't be an issue. Cash bail becomes a problem when people are held on nonviolent offenses that prevent them from getting out of jail, but they're members of the community. So if the recommendations are followed, then we can avoid incarcerating people inappropriately. This is a issue near and dear to my heart because I was part of the team as an assistant district attorney who developed mental health court in Allegheny County. I had an opportunity to create a court where we brought individuals in with mental health challenges, treated them, talked to the victims of the crime, and made them understand the reasons the crime occurred and that treatment is a better result because then the person won't go back to the court system. I saw the amazing transformation of people entering the court and then leaving the court completely in a better situation and going on to lead happy and productive lives. I believe that a more collaborative approach to justice in some cases when society is not endangered makes a lot of sense, that it should be more of that in the courts. And if I'm elected, I would love to serve as a judge on mental health court, to create other specialty courts that I'd be happy to serve on in the family division, more in the criminal division. We already have a drug court, but we can expand that as well. So I believe very much in restorative justice and reaching a more collaborative result through specialty courts.
Hi, my name is Richard Thomas Ernsberger, and I'm running for judge of the Court of Common Pleas. I'd like to thank the League of Women Voters for having me here to discuss two very important issues with you. The first issue is, what is my view on cash bail? Now, as an attorney and as a judicial candidate, I'm a firm believer in equal access and equal justice before the courts and the ability to come before the court and have equal representation no matter who you are, whether you're a corporation or an individual. Now, in Pennsylvania, there are five ways that bail is established. The first way is release on your own recognizance. The second way is release on special conditions. The third way is release on an unsecured bond. The fourth is, you know, you get released on a bond. And the fifth is cash bail. Now, cash bail has become increasingly controversial over the years for a large number of reasons. It's seen as disproportionately impacting both the minorities and the poor. And for people who can't afford cash, who are of low income, they can't afford cash bail, and it may make it impossible for them to get out of prison, and it may place further harm in their lives. They may not be able to afford rent or impact their ability with work. For minorities, cash bail is seen as being issued in a higher amount relative to other ethnicities. And because of that, it's seen as inequitable. Now, cash bail is initially established at the magistrate level. And after that, it can come to the Court of Common Pleas where the judge would look at it and has the opportunity to change it under the rules. And any cash bail that would come before me, I would motion for cash bail modification. I would look at it under the rules, applicable rules and statutory law, with understanding that when you're coming before the court, you're coming there and you expect equal justice for everybody and equal treatment under the law. And that's how I would approach cash bail, that there are other alternatives to it. And it should be, if your cash bail is issued, it should be done with the utmost consideration for the law and equal justice under the law. Now, the second issue before me that I was asked to discuss is specialty courts and restorative justice. Now, I truly support specialty courts and restorative justice. I think that anything that can cut back on the amount of incarceration and help individuals get back into our society is a good option for our courts and for the justice system, especially equal justice for all. My name is Richard Thomas Ernsberger. I'm running for judge of the Court of Common Pleas. I'd like to ask for your vote in May. If you'd like to learn more about me, please visit my website, rernsbergerforjudge.com. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Nicola Henry Taylor, and I'm a candidate for the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. As we know, cash bail is statutory. However, in Allegheny County, the bail authority, the pretrial services, they're not recommending it. But many magistrates are still implementing it. We could be much more creative in trying to make sure that we are not disadvantaging poor people and people of color. If we look at the Allegheny County Jail, there are a large number of people who are in the jail waiting pretrial detention. And what ultimately happens is they end up spending more time in the jail than they would have if they would have pled guilty. We also have sometimes people pleading guilty in order to get out of jail when they may not have been guilty. So obviously there's a huge issue with cash bail. We need to do more. We need to be more creative. We could look at best practices from other jurisdictions. And we also need to look at this as a legislative issue, which our President Judge Kim Berkeley Clark has also indicated. I have a very special place in my heart for specialty courts and problem-solving courts. As an assistant district attorney in Allegheny County, I headed the mental health court program. I know how important it is to have multidisciplinary discussions and programs where people can have an opportunity to have a continuum of care throughout the process. Having social workers, having specialized probation officers, having a specialized judge involved is very important. People then are looked at as human beings given dignity and not necessarily looked at as people who are just a number in the system. So I think we need to improve programs like mental health court, veterans court, pride court, and Phoenix court, and those types of things. We need to do better and eliminate where people are getting convictions to be in these programs, but just make sure that they're more expansive and also doing them at the magistrate level, where when I was an assistant DA, we did a drug court with Judge Wida in Bethel Park. So we need to do more of that. Thank you.
My name is George Heim, and I'm running for Allegheny County Common Pleas Court. My position on cash bail is that there are only two legal reasons for using cash bail. First, to protect society from dangerous individuals. And second, to ensure that people show up for court appearances. If a person is truly a danger to society, then cash bail might be appropriate. Otherwise, we shouldn't be using cash bail at all. When we do, all we're doing is criminalizing poverty. We should release most people on their own recognizance, and then and only then, if they fail to show up for a court appearance without just cause, they could be incarcerated. This would actually use less resources than incarcerating people in the Allegheny County Jail to ensure that they come to court. We should always remember that the United States and Pennsylvania constitutions guarantee a presumption of innocence. This means that pretrial detention should always be a last resort. Finally, Common Pleas Court judges should be reviewing cash bail decisions by magistrates within days, not weeks or months, when it's too late. We must do better in this area. We should be completely focused on restorative justice in Allegheny County. While we have made some strides with specialty courts in this area, there is much still to be done. In Allegheny County, we have several specialty courts, including mental health court, veterans court, DUI court, and drug court. These programs do allow people to avoid incarceration and provide rehabilitative resources. As a defense attorney, I very often get my clients into these programs so that they can take advantage of those resources. However, we need to do more. The problem with the specialty courts as they exist now in Allegheny County is that individuals must plead guilty to enter the program and take advantage of those resources. When a person goes through rehab or mental health counseling and gets themselves on track, the first thing they're going to do is look for housing and employment. The problem is, the way things work now, they've now been saddled with a criminal conviction, which follows them and harms them. We need to set up specialty courts that are offered pre-charging so that people have the opportunity in nonviolent defenses to take advantage of those resources without being charged with the crime. And if they are successful in doing so, they won't be charged at all. This way, they can move on and become productive members of society. We need to stop criminalizing addiction and mental illness in Allegheny County. Thank you.
I've worked in the Allegheny County criminal justice system for the past 20 plus years of my legal career. First as a prosecutor, as a defense attorney, as a director of the public defender's office, and most recently as a judge in the criminal division for the last 2 years. I am vehemently opposed to the utilization of cash bail. It does, while it is well-intentioned, we believe that it will ensure the return of a person accused of committing a crime. They'll appear for court and it will keep our community safe, but it doesn't do that. It does nothing more than discriminate against people from low-income communities who lack the resources to post bail. And so what you see happening is people just languish in jail for periods of 6 to 8 months waiting for their case to be resolved. And ultimately, when those cases are resolved, more likely than not, the person will receive a period of a sentence of probation. So I'm opposed to the utilization of cash bail. It does nothing but penalize people for being poor, and it wastes resources. As a director of the public defender's office, we had a number of initiatives that we implemented, I'm very proud of. But two of the initiatives that we had were, one, we hired social workers to work with the attorneys in bail hearings to address bail. We had an 18% success rate of getting people out who otherwise would have languished in jail due to their inability to post bail. But the other thing we did is we had developed a motions practice. Whenever a person received a monetary condition of bail, we would represent people in those hearings, and we would file motions within 24 hours to try to get people out of jail. And we had an 80% success rate there. And that does two things. It saves lives, it saves resources, it allows people to deal with their legal matters from home instead of sitting in jail and needlessly languishing in jail for 6 to 8 months. So I am vehemently opposed to the utilization of cash bail. As a judge, I'm keenly aware that there are a number of diversionary courts in our court system. We have mental health court, we have drug court, we also have veterans court. But unfortunately, to qualify for the services that these diversionary courts offer, you have to plead guilty. So as a veteran, you go to the court, you need services, you need assistance, but you have to plead guilty. So when you plead guilty to get the help, while you will receive help, you also leave the criminal justice system with a conviction. And what that means is you'll have issues getting gainful employment, you'll have issues with housing. And I don't believe that if we really set out and it's our intention to help people, we should do everything we can to help them. We shouldn't have them leave the court system saddled with a conviction. And unfortunately, that's the unfortunate reality of the situation when we talk about our diversionary courts in Allegheny County. We need to help people. We need to give them the services and the help that they need to lessen the likelihood that they will return to the front door of our court system. And currently, we do not do that. As a judge, I've always been committed to fashioning sentences which implement or utilize alternatives to incarceration. When we talk about the resources, when we talk about people's lives, and we talk about people being in a position to move on after paying their debt to society, as judges, we have an obligation to utilize sentences that allow people to do that.
Hello, my name is Clint Kelly. I'm running for judge in the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. Limiting the opportunity for bail to only those people who can afford to pay for it is simply just wrong. We need to have a system for bail in Allegheny County where there are opportunities for conditions that people who cannot afford bail, conditions that they can meet such that they are still given the opportunity for bail. The example of these conditions that come to mind are things like, if you are working, get work release. If you qualify for house arrest, get on house arrest. If it's appropriate, refrain from use of drugs and alcohol. And if you meet these conditions, even though you cannot afford bail, you still have the opportunity to receive bail in the criminal justice system. This keeps people from being incarcerated before they have been proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. And the opportunity for that should not be limited to those people who can afford bail as opposed to those people who can't. Special courts and restorative justice programs are necessary steps in our criminal justice system, which we cannot ignore. The special court programs that are in place right now are working, but it's simply not enough. There are other instances and other segments of the population beyond what we already have where these programs can be useful in helping our citizens of Allegheny County. And what the judges need to do is the judges need to create an additional diversionary program or special court to address the needs of this next segment of the population. And then the segment after that, and the segment after that. And the benefit to all this is that those people who would not necessarily be appropriate for incarceration would be able to continue to exist and contribute in our society rather than being placed in jail. And that's an important step that we need to make sure that we follow. Again, I'm Clint Kelly and I'm running for judge in the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sabrina Corbell. I'm one of the candidates for the Court of Common Pleas. And I first want to take a moment to thank the League of Women Voters for giving me this opportunity to tell you a little bit more about my work and to answer a few questions. So I am the legal director at the Women's Center and Shelter of Greater Pittsburgh. I've worked there for nearly the last 20 years, standing with and providing free legal representation to victims of domestic violence in over 7,000 cases, primarily in the area of family law. It's been an absolute honor to do that work, and I would love to take that experience to the bench. Now, with regard to the matters and the questions raised concerning cash bail, we know that generally cash bail is set at the magisterial district judge level. We know that from recent reports, the use of cash bail has created racial disparities, over-incarceration, and a reliance on fees paid by litigants using the system. So we need to end the use of cash bail because it absolutely affects our most marginalized communities and those who are most resource burdened. But what do common pleas judges have to do with that? Well, at the common pleas level, judges can take a leadership role with state legislators to show the impact of cash bail on the folks who are coming before them and advocate for change at the legislative level. They can also be committed to faster bail review hearings, unnecessary continuances, and the use of pre-incarceration only when it's necessary for safety reasons. So that brings us to the second question, I think, which is that we need to prioritize the use of restorative justice programs. But restorative justice programs are about connecting people to resources. So again, common pleas judges can take leadership roles to make sure that at local and state levels, resources have adequate funding. We know that those resources over time have been not funded at the levels that they should be. But more than that, we need to look at all access to restorative justice programs, those that deal with mental health issues, drug and alcohol treatment, counseling, therapeutic access. It really is an access issue. And because of that, we need to look at restorative justice in a holistic way, across the board with all our divisions. And the best example I can tell you that I've worked on is the use of batterers intervention programs so that folks who are trying to change battering behavior have access to therapeutic and educational resources that can do that. And recently we were able to incorporate that not only in the criminal justice system, but also in the family division. And this is just the start. We need to focus on access, focus on restorative justice, and bring our courts back to our communities so that people are able to connect with resources that will change their lives. And that's the type of judge and the type of work that I'm committed to being. And I want to thank you again.
My name is Brian Malkin. I'm running for one of 9 seats as a Court of Common Pleas judge. I live in the North Hills with my wife and 3 teen daughters where I serve as a councilman. I am in my 27th year as a practicing trial attorney. Over the years, I have represented individuals, businesses, and governments in court. I have fought for the rights of folks who are injured, disabled, discriminated against, and unemployed. The reason why voting for a judge in this election is so important is because that judge will decide how folks in the criminal justice system are treated. That treatment includes sentencing and fines. The decisions that your new judges make to reduce the jail and prison population will affect everybody in the community. Black nonviolent offenders have for years been disparately impacted by overzealous sentencing, fines, and technical probation violations. This practice has decimated families and communities in our county. To heal, we should stop spending money on punishment and jail. Putting that money into education and social services that help heal is how we lower crime rates in our underserved communities. It's obvious that cash bail is unfair to folks that have no resources. It creates a debtor's prison. We keep accused folks in jail while they lose their jobs, homes, and loved ones. Spending over $100 per day to ensure that they return for a court date where their possible penalty does not include jail time. Eliminating cash bail for nonviolent offenders is crucial. There is no income review before bail is imposed, and that makes it arbitrary and unfair. We need our judges to review bail decisions made by district judges so we can get these folks out of jail. We know that 90% of defendants released of their own recognizance will return for their court date, so why pay to keep them in jail? Another measure that will greatly reduce the jail and prison population is restorative justice, a system where victims are given a chance to meet with or communicate with the first-time offender. Restorative justice gives a victim a chance to be heard on how they've been injured by the crime. The process helps the offender understand the impact their actions had on the victim, creating accountability and the possible chance to make amends. The offender may work towards restitution or provide community service as part of a non-punitive sentence. We know that such programs in other parts of the country have greatly reduced repeat offenders from returning and help to reduce the jail and prison population. Eliminating cash bail and restorative justice are powerful measures our courts need to accomplish now, and if elected, I will help institute these changes. You can find more out about me and my campaign at malkinforjudge.com. I'm Brian Malkin, and I appreciate your time today. Thanks.
I really appreciate these two questions because I think they both reflect the concerns that we have about our criminal legal system, the main one, which is mass incarceration. So the question of bail really informs pretrial incarceration. When a person is arrested, a magistrate sets a bail. And if a magistrate sets a bail that requires a person to pay money to get out of jail, that's really just criminalizing poverty. So we need a mechanism by which common pleas court judges can review the decisions that magistrates make and review them much earlier in the process. When you talk about specialty courts and restorative justice processes, you should be talking about ways to divert people out of the criminal legal system. But unfortunately, here in Allegheny County, specialty courts aren't really that special. They're just a different place where you plead guilty, where you can receive treatment and support. What we really need are specialty courts where you don't have to plead guilty, and that the reward at the end of fulfilling your obligations is to not have a criminal conviction. Because criminal convictions, much like incarceration, can lead to loss of jobs, loss of housing, sometimes even loss of custody of your children. If we can use restorative justice processes as well to empower not only the people who are accused of the crimes, but victims and the community, then we will not only help the individual, the offender, we'll also actually be able to find people and community-centered solutions to the real causes of crime.
Hello, my friends. This is Attorney Joseph Patrick Murphy. I'm 51 years old, and I live in Pine Township with my family. I've been practicing law for a little over 20 years, and this year I'm running for judge right here in Allegheny County. Before I begin my presentation, I want to give a moment of thanks to the League of Women Voters of Greater Pittsburgh. I want to thank them for this opportunity to reach out to voters like you. The League of Women Voters has asked each candidate for judge to submit a video and discuss two important topics. The first topic is the topic of ending cash bail. Ending cash bail is something of a hot topic right now. In fact, I already have a video out on the subject, but it's too long for this format. It comes in at about 8 minutes. If you'd like to see my video on ending cash bail, you can see that on the Friends of Joseph Patrick Murphy YouTube channel. There are plenty of good emotional and social justice reasons to want to end cash bail, but I come at the topic from a more pragmatic perspective. The bottom line is we all live in a high-tech surveillance state. The phones, the traffic cams, the GPS, no one can just run away anymore. We simply don't need cash bail to prevent people from running away. The other problem with cash bail is that it can result in holding people in jail who are legally innocent. Someone who's been arrested is not a criminal, they're a defendant. They're legally presumed innocent. If that person cannot or will not post bail, we end up in the ridiculous situation where we're holding legally innocent people in prison. The employment and economic demands on all of us now are so extreme, we're all holding on by our fingernails. Can you imagine spending a couple months in jail, being found innocent at trial, and then released only to find that you have no job and no home to go to? Sometimes the force of history and tradition can be so powerful that we're not willing to look at what we're doing. In many cases, the use of cash bail is causing more problems for society than it's solving. Eliminating cash bail is an idea whose time may have come. The second topic the League of Women Voters asked all of us candidates to discuss in these videos is the subject of specialty courts and restorative justice. I strongly support the use of specialty courts and even inventing new specialty courts to deal with other sociological problems that are not really the evidence of criminal intention. On a similar note, I really like these restorative justice ideas. Our current justice system is what's called retributive justice. We lock people up as punishment, as retribution. Restorative justice focuses on having the offender accept culpability for their wrongful conduct and giving the community an opportunity to have a role in forgiveness, redirection of the offender, and even empowerment of the victims. I once heard a law professor refer to the law as the minimum amount of love that we'll accept from citizens in our society. These restorative justice proposals may be the minimum amount of love that our society will accept from the law. My name is Joseph Patrick Murphy. I'm running for judge right here in Allegheny County. I hope you'll support me.
I'm proud to say that I was the first elected official in Allegheny County to take the position that we should end our reliance on cash bail in Pennsylvania. As a proven leader for criminal justice reform in our region, I know that cash bail is a deep source of systemic inequity that does not promote public safety. I'm sure we can agree, we should not be releasing dangerous persons just because they have access to money, while incarcerating low to moderate risk persons just because they can't pay. As a district judge, I have eliminated my reliance on cash bail, and as a judge in the Court of Common Pleas, I will work to eliminate cash bail throughout Allegheny County by ensuring that judges have an abundance of safer, more equitable, more restorative alternatives. The fact is that we as a society over-rely on arrest and incarceration to solve our social problems. That is why the United States represents 5% of the world's population and 25% of its prison population. This imbalance is driven by gross racial disparities in arrest and incarceration, and Allegheny County is not exempt. Over 60% of the Allegheny County jail population is persons of color, while persons of color represent less than 20% of the overall population in Allegheny County. We simply must end mass incarceration in Allegheny County, and the use of special courts and restorative justice as alternatives to incarceration, I believe, are key components of an overall strategy to do this.
Hi, my name is Chuck Porter, and I would like to thank the League of Women Voters for the opportunity to address the citizens of Allegheny County as it relates to the upcoming May election. With respect to cash bond, my position is cash bond should never be used to hold someone in jail simply because they cannot afford to post a bail. If one feels that a person is a danger to the community or a flight risk, conditions can be imposed to address that. Otherwise, cash bail should not be set that would prevent people from making a bond. Having said that, as I've said before, cash bond is essentially a red herring in this election. All the candidates are talking about it. The reality is the bonds are set by the magisterial district judges. We have a mechanism in Allegheny County for an appeal of that bond. That appeal goes to the motions judge of the Court of Common Pleas, and the motions judge addresses the bond issues. So common pleas court judges in Allegheny County, with the exception of the motions judge, are not addressing the bond issues. So for people to talk about this with great regularity, it's just trying to basically ask voters to recognize them for an issue they're never going to address, almost without fail. The use of specialty courts in Allegheny County is of critical importance and is one of the best things I've recognized in my 36 years of practicing in the Courts of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. We have probably 95% of the crimes that come before the courts have a drug, alcohol, or mental health component to them. Giving people who have offended in those areas the ability to get treatment is, in my mind, an extremely important opportunity and obligation that we have as a society. If we can help people who have a mental health, drug, or alcohol problem get back on the right path, then it's critically important and is certainly a better option than incarceration for such people. The use of veterans court, in my mind, is also an extremely important court because, as we all know and recognize, veterans are the ones who have given us the ability as Americans to have the system of justice that we have. And it's extremely important to give those folks who have fought for us the ability to treat whatever problems they have encountered given the service they've given to our country. So that's critically important. Restorative justice is another component that can work in certain circumstances where it's an appropriate circumstance not to re-victimize a victim by giving them and the accused the ability to interact. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Zeke Redeker and I'm running for the Allegheny County Court of Common Pleas. I want to thank the League of Women Voters for allowing me to submit this video. I'm running for judge because I'm passionate about my hometown of Pittsburgh, ensuring access to justice for all people, and our judiciary. I'm running to draw attention to two main issues, criminal justice reform and fair housing. Regarding the League of Women Voters' first question about cash bail, I think that judges need to use their discretion to limit the circumstances under which they impose cash bail. There are many studies that have come out that have shown that cash bail disproportionately affects low-income communities of color. If you can't pay your bail and you have to go sit in Allegheny County Jail, there is a very good likelihood that you could lose your job. I don't know of any job where you can take multiple months off and have it be ready for you upon return. You could lose your home if you have a mortgage or you pay rent. the likelihood that if you don't have a job and you're not living in that home and you're sitting in Allegheny County Jail that you're going to be paying your rent or your mortgage is very small. And there are also family consequences. If you take care of a dependent family member or you need to take care of your children, you can't do those things when you're sitting in Allegheny County Jail. So I think judges need to be very careful about the circumstances under which they impose cash bail. The second thing I want to talk to you about is restorative justice. One of the big parts of my platform is to create a restorative justice program for first-time offenders, and it could also be used for juveniles. The point of restorative justice is to convene stakeholders. You have the person who committed the offense. You have the person who was harmed by the offense or the victim. You have people in the community who may be harmed by the offense. And then you have social service providers, as well as a trained mediator. And all of these groups come together to try to do real justice. They try to heal, create as much healing as possible, and also provide the person who was wronged what they need in order to move forward. The restorative justice is also designed to reduce recidivism. Because when you take a person and you give them access to resources, whether it's job resources, mental health counseling, drug counseling, but the ability to put that person on the right path, that's the best way to go about creating justice. In these kinds of situations, courts need to be rehabilitative and not punitive. I want to thank the League of Women Voters for allowing me to present to you today, and I look forward very much to engaging with you in the future. Thank you.
With respect to cash bail, I'm an advocate for reforming the system in a manner that decriminalizes poverty. Currently, there are too many individuals that are in our jails for minor crimes, drug possession, and things of those nature, that the only reason that they're sitting in jail for 6-9 months awaiting trial is because they don't have the means to be able to get out of jail where you know, other people and other individuals that are wealthier are. So it's unfairly impacting minorities and the impoverished. With respect to those types of crimes, I would advocate for the elimination of cash bail as it's unnecessary. With respect to violent crimes, crimes of a sexual nature, and domestic violence crimes, however, I would not advocate for zero cash bail. There has to be some consideration paid for respecting the witnesses and protecting the victims of those crimes. And I certainly wouldn't be in favor of returning a domestic violence abuser to the same household within 72 hours of the report being given. So I'm a very strong advocate for the use of special courts in sentencing. The diversionary programs such as mental health courts, veterans court, and even the ARD program for first-time offenders are wonderful at reducing recidivism. A lot of the times the people that are coming through court system and are able to utilize those programs have underlying issues. They have mental health issues or they have drug and alcohol issues. So to provide those people with the resources to overcome those problems that they're dealing with really prevents them from having to come back to the court system again. So they are wonderful tools for the judges in Pennsylvania. The other tool that the courts do have now is restorative justice programs. And to the extent that it's appropriate, getting the victim, the perpetrator, and hopefully the community members involved in getting together, discussing the experience that the victim and perpetrator had, and then discussing how the perpetrator can make right the wrong that they had caused is really a wonderful way of healing the community and is really best for everybody involved.
My name is Giuseppe Roselli, and I'm a candidate for judge on the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County. Regarding the question of the application of cash bail, I believe attaching one's financial ability to their freedom is offensive and has no place in any system that calls itself just. Regarding the question related to diversion over incarceration, I fully support that. However, I believe it needs to be expanded. And what I mean by that is, and here in Allegheny County, we have diversion court programs in place, dealing with mental health court, drug court, DUI court, and veterans court. These courts have identified underlying contributing causes to criminal behavior. And because we've identified those underlying contributing causes, we deem those individuals worthy of resources rather than incarceration. We want to provide a plan in place for that individual to follow. I fully support that. However, we fall short in three very specific ways. The first is we do not include poverty and lack of opportunity as an underlying contributing cause worthy of diversion. It should be. Second, we start too late. And what I mean by that is our diversion programs and the eligibility into those programs require an individual's next step to be incarceration, which means they've been through the system 3, 4, 5 times. This is backwards. We should be providing those resources as soon as possible in an effort to avoid the return into the system 3, 4, 5 times. Last, upon completion, we currently require a conviction. And it's that conviction that oftentimes creates the societal harm to the individual, their family, and the community as a whole. So if an individual walks through a program, complies at every step, is accountable for their actions that brought them there, I see no reason why they must leave the program with a conviction. So I believe in diversion over conviction. Thank you. Be well.
Hi. My name is Jimmy Sheets, and I am running for the Allegheny County Court of Common Pleas. I want to start by thanking the League of Women Voters for this opportunity to address your organization and your viewers. I have been working in the criminal court system for in excess of 20 years. In 2000, I started the Allegheny County Public Defender's Office and spent 5 years representing the criminally accused at preliminary hearings, formal arraignments, pretrial conferences, and ultimately at trial. I have done hundreds, if not thousands, of non-jury trials and scores of jury trials. In 2005, I started my own practice where I continued to represent the criminally accused, both privately and court-appointed. I think it's important that people know when someone's running for judge that they have experience in the courtroom, that they have tried cases both to judges and to juries, and I have done that on hundreds and thousands of occasions. I've also argued bond for thousands of people. When it comes to bond, I think that before a judge sets a cash bond, it is very important that the judge consider those factors most important. Whether or not the person is an imminent threat to the community, the person's prior criminal record, the charges that are in front of the judge at that moment, and the person's willingness to show up or not show up for court. Through pretrial services, justice-related services, we have ample opportunity to avoid setting cash bonds, and those opportunities ought to be taken whenever possible. But if in the event a cash bond must be set, if elected to the Court of Common Pleas, I would set one. As it relates to incarceration, for 20 years, I have fought on an almost daily basis to keep people out of jail, to get people out of jail. The means through which I have done that is relationships. Relationships with law enforcement, victims advocacy groups, different rehabilitative organizations, with the district attorney's office, and with law enforcement. It's through forming these relationships that I have been able to help people avoid incarceration. A lot of times the work has been done by my client, preemptively taking rehabilitative steps that a judge would consider when deciding whether or not to incarcerate someone or not. Quite frankly, if elected to the bench, I would do the same thing. At every opportunity, if given the chance of incarcerating someone or diverting them, I would choose to divert them. I thank you again for this opportunity to address the organization.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Sizemore, and I'm running for the Court of Common Pleas here in Allegheny County. My position on cash bail is that we should abolish cash bail in Pennsylvania. It hasn't lived up to the promise of what it said it will do, and instead it's been a tax on the poor. By eliminating cash bail, we can go a long way towards eliminating mass incarceration and to reducing racial and ethnic disparities in our criminal legal system. There are conditions and combinations of conditions that we can put forward that will ensure the safety of the community, whether it's the community overall or a specific alleged victim pre-trial, that will eliminate the use of money, but will ensure that everyone's needs can be met in the system. I don't believe that there's a reason to use cash bail to do that. And I am one of, if not the only candidate in the race who has practiced in a jurisdiction without cash bail, Washington, D.C., where I practiced for 8 years. So I have a strong idea in my head of some conditions that we could set around which people would be released from jail pretrial. It doesn't mean that everyone would have the opportunity to be released pretrial, but it would significantly reduce our jail population, reduce the amount of money taxpayers are paying to incarcerate people pretrial, honor our constitutional right to innocent until proven guilty, the presumption of innocence, and it would also reduce racial and ethnic disparities. So I support the elimination of cash bail. With regard to the use of diversionary courts and other restorative practice programs, I strongly support them. My change that I would make to our current diversionary court practices is that I would hope that we could change our diversionary court programming to really allow people to not have to plead guilty prior to entering these courts. My hope is that we could create a pretrial diversionary court system that really allows people to engage with services, but without the toll of a conviction on their record, especially because in Pennsylvania, there are only a small number of offenses for which record sealing is even a possibility. So when you weigh those two systems, I think that it mitigates in favor of having pretrial diversionary courts. I strongly support restorative practices at all levels of the system, not just for low-level offenses, not just for minor offenses, but even for very serious offenses. I think that victim-offender dialogue, mediation, and other healing work with the support of professionals can be incredibly helpful, even at the highest level of cases that we see in our system. So I hope that this helps you get to understand me a little bit as a candidate. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Beth Tracy Sinatra. Thank you to Judy and the rest of the dedicated team at the League of Women Voters. Leave it to a woman to adjust to these unusual circumstances and still make this forum happen so voters can learn about the candidates and make an informed decision. Taking away someone's liberty is very serious. Detaining a low-risk defendant for even 3 days showed they were almost twice as likely to reoffend opposed to defendants who were released. Pretrial liberty should be utilized as often as possible. The resulting job loss and housing insecurity of detention can put low-risk defendants and their families in a situation that could have serious negative consequences. I believe using cash bail should be used sparingly and used only when there are reasonable concerns to preserve public safety or there are reasonable concerns that the accused will not appear for court. Rules of criminal procedure are very clear on the application of monetary bail, outlining criteria the court shall use, including the financial ability of the defendant, employment status, and if the accused is a flight risk. It goes on to say that bail shall be reasonable. When the word shall is used, that is an order. It's not voluntary, meaning that we must consider and abide by the directive. Judges can choose to assign monetary or non-monetary bail, and conditions like travel restrictions, stay away orders, nominal bail, where a small amount of money, like $1, is given and another person acts as surety. We have the ability to keep people safe and have collateral or other conditions that help ensure defendants appear at future hearings. Cash bail has been overused and has disproportionately impacted facets of our society. To answer your second question, I absolutely believe that there is a component of the law that is intended to be rehabilitative. We have a responsibility to the public to reintroduce people into society that are restored. I believe we have a responsibility to use the discretion of the court to maximize the law's therapeutic potential. Allegheny County has implemented a number of diversionary programs which have a tremendous amount of success treating the underlying cause of criminality, reducing recidivism, and helping individuals who are struggling. Additionally, the DSM-5 recognizes substance use disorder as a mental health disorder, making diversionary programs such as drug court, mental health court, and veterans court a holistic approach to the law that also addresses a public health crisis. And we should be utilizing them. We also need to be more trauma-informed and recognize the correlation and intervene before it becomes a pathology to prevent the school-to-prison pipeline.
Hello, my name is Patrick Sweeney. I'm an attorney with the Public Defender's Office, where I've worked for the last 23 years. I'm appearing before you from my living room here on the north side. I thank you for taking the time to educate yourself about my campaign, and I thank the League of Women Voters especially for providing us with this forum. The League has asked us to discuss two issues, bail reform, cash bail in particular, as well as alternative sentencing and restorative justice as a change in policy. Both of those issues are things that I care very deeply about because as a public defender, my client base has the most to gain or lose by whether or not we achieve reform in those two areas. First, cash bail. I think it should be used very sparingly, if not be completely eliminated. The only time I would see cash bail as being appropriate is if someone who is a criminal defendant who is from out of Allegheny County perhaps needs a little added incentive to make their way back to the courthouse. Otherwise, even in that instance, the bail amount shouldn't be so high that they can't afford to pay it. My clients are the ones who are sitting in jail because they can't afford to pay their bond, and it really hamstrings their ability to assist in their own defense. Criminal defendants are their own best advocates, more so than I am. They can track down witnesses. They can track down medical records, financial records. They know their case in and out better than I do and know where to find things to help. And if they are incarcerated simply because they're poor, that creates an injustice and an imbalance in our equitable system of justice that favors those with money over those without. It runs afoul of the presumption of innocence. No one should be locked up simply on an accusation before they've had their day in court and before they've been proven guilty of anything. Getting to the second question, what are my thoughts about alternative sentencing and restorative justice? Restorative justice is a term that is often misunderstood. It's been making the rounds politically and in policy circles. What I see restorative justice as encompassing is finding alternatives to incarceration to attempt to address the root causes of crime and to prevent recidivism. Judge Dower used to always say that the overwhelming majority of defendants in a criminal justice system are there because of drugs and alcohol, and he's right. But the drugs and alcohol are often symptoms of a pre-existing mental health disorder that they are perhaps self-medicating. The overwhelming majority of my clients are suffering from one of the other, either alcohol or drug abuse or mental health, and very often both. We should expand those treatment courts, but we should also consider making them pre-conviction as opposed to post-conviction so people can work towards an expungement or a reduction in charges. Right now, it's the other way around. I thank you for your time.
My name is Andy Zeffi. I'm the Allegheny County Solicitor, and I'm a candidate for the Court of Common Pleas. And thank you to the League of Women Voters of Greater Pittsburgh for providing the candidates with this opportunity. We'll get right to the questions. The first one about my position on the use of cash bail. As the county solicitor, the second largest consumer of services from the Allegheny County Law Department that I oversee is the Allegheny County Jail. I've seen everything in that jail firsthand, and I know that there are people in that jail who should not be there. Allegheny County, we're one of the leaders in the state of sentencing people to probation and sentencing people to cash bail. Simply put, there are a lot of people in the Allegheny County Jail who are there on technical violations and probation violations, nonviolent charges, who, if they plead guilty and when their charges are resolved, will never face a day in jail. So there is no logical explanation by which you could say someone is spending time in jail on charges that will never result in jail time. So when a magistrate imposes cash bail and that is not overturned by the Court of Common Pleas, that operates as a sentence against that person. And in that sentence, whether they're there for a month, 2 months, 3 months, while they're awaiting trial, they may not be able to pay rent, support their families, lose a job. It makes absolutely no sense under any model to impose cash bail in those circumstances. With regard to the second question on the use of restorative justice and diversionary courts, 100%, jail should be a last result. We've seen successful implementation of Phoenix Court and other models, diversionary courts in the Court of Common Pleas. We should absolutely use them. What more so, we should provide options to utilize those prior to convictions. So someone doesn't have to be convicted of a crime and be saddled with that conviction going forward if they could be diverted out of the normal criminal justice system. With regard to the restorative justice question, I think that's a model that can absolutely work. We see it piloted across the country in states like Colorado, in California. I've participated in hundreds of mediations in my time in private practice and as county solicitor. And when both parties come to the table willing for that system, that model to work, I've seen that it does work. There is no need to senselessly clog our jails and our criminal justice system with cases that can be resolved through that model, so I would be fully in support of it. Our judges need to be enabled by the legislature to utilize it as an alternative to sentencing, but when their discretion allows it, or if the legislative structure does allow it, then absolutely our judges should utilize it. There's no question about it. Jail should be a last resort, and we need to elect judges who will adopt that philosophy. I want to thank you for your time. Thank you for viewing this. Thank you for caring about this election. Again, my name is Andy Zeffie. You will find me in the middle of your ballot on May 18th. Please go out and vote. Thank you very much.
Bail in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania is set by magisterial district judges. As a candidate for the Allegheny County Court of Common Pleas, I promise to review the bail status of every incarcerated defendant within 1 week of the case being assigned to my courtroom. In reviewing bail status, I will use two factors: whether or not the defendant poses a risk to the community or the victim in the case, and whether or not the defendant will appear for court. Race and socioeconomic status are not to be used in considering bail. I promise to apply the law equally and fairly to all who appear before me, and I will do so in reviewing bail status of incarcerated defendants. In Allegheny County, we're fortunate to have diversionary programs such as mental health court, drug court, DUI court, and veterans court. As a former prosecutor and now a criminal defense attorney, I've had the opportunity to take advantage of each and every one of those courts for one of my clients. In doing so, I know the value of giving a second chance to nonviolent offenders. As a candidate for the Court of Common Pleas, I will work for giving everyone a second chance who is a nonviolent offender and meets the criteria for each and every one of these courts. We're very fortunate to have the resources here in Allegheny County to make a difference in people's lives and make sure that incarceration is not our first choice, but can be our last alternative. And as a candidate, I promise you I will do everything in my power to make sure that defendants are given the opportunity to use these diversionary courts. Thank you.
Hi, this is Allegheny County Controller Chelsea Wagner, candidate for judge on the Court of Common Pleas of Allegheny County, providing my responses to the two questions. First, my position on cash bail. I think it is important that we frame this in terms of what works and what doesn't. Studies have shown overwhelmingly in jurisdictions where cash bail has been eliminated that the purported purpose of cash bail, and that it's supposed to have defendants, those accused of crimes, return for their court dates. In the jurisdictions where cash bail has been eliminated, defendants are showing up just as much and sometimes even more for court. But more concerningly, we know that cash bail disproportionately harms people of color and poor defendants who are caught up in our legal system, whereas their white counterparts often get less harsh applications or assessments of cash bail and oftentimes have more ability to pay. So it results in a two-tiered system that is not just, and therefore we absolutely do need to reform cash bail. Secondly, on using special courts or restorative justice in sentencing decisions. Same concept in terms of what works and what doesn't. Studies and our own experience here in Allegheny County and across the state have shown that restorative justice programs, these diversionary courts, absolutely do work. The problem, however, is that we are not investing in them as heavily as we must. In the last year for which data is available for Pennsylvania, here in Allegheny County, only 13% of criminal defendants went through our diversionary courts. Only 52 individuals went through mental health court. So we know that we need to expand programming, we need to expand eligibility, but we also need to expand funding. We know these programs are underfunded, not just in Allegheny County, but across the state. So this is why we need leaders on the bench. And what I've demonstrated is a commitment to reform, but also the ability to work with government leaders, with foundation leaders, activists, the business community, to really invest in these synergies that we have right now to implement reform. Because it's one thing for all of us to say that we are committed to these reforms and we believe that they need to happen, but it's another thing for us to take on the leadership to get them done. I'm someone who has written bills to increase court funding as a legislator and a member of the Judiciary Committee and worked diligently to reform the jail. That's the kind of leadership that I will bring to the bench. Thank you.
I support efforts to reform cash bail. It is an issue that is at the forefront of our broken criminal justice system. Cash bail perpetuates inequities in the justice system that are disproportionately felt by communities of color and those experiencing poverty. Bail is intended to ensure people return to court. However, it has become a system that has morphed into widespread lack of wealth-based incarceration. As a former judge of the Pittsburgh Magistrates Court, I know the need for this reform firsthand. We have far too many defendants locked up in Allegheny County Jail awaiting trial or sentencing who could be working to provide for their families, caring for their families, pursuing an education, and other things needed to get their lives on track. However, the current system is a barrier to those without the means to pay. Poorer Americans and people of color often cannot afford to come up with the money for bail, leaving them languishing in jail. It seems the system punishes prior to conviction. Throughout my legal career, I have always worked to be fair to all, and I pledge to continue that as we work to transform this current cash bail system so that we reduce the overuse and misuse of our jails. Thank you. I fully support the use of special courts and restorative justice in sentencing as an alternative to incarceration. One of the goals for those convicted and/or adjudicated is to become contributing, productive citizens. A balanced and restorative system that provides justice for the victim and family members while offering opportunities for rehabilitative restoration to civility should be a fundamental aspect of the judicial system. While keeping the community safe, we should have relevant programs, including job opportunities, training, counseling, and using partnerships and collaborations with corporations and organizations and community organizations to restore members to their deserved place as contributing citizens. Juvenile court has long used the balanced and restorative justice system. In both juvenile and criminal, there are first-time offender programs which offer the opportunity to have your charges dismissed or withdrawn following the successful completion of the terms and conditions of probation. Currently, the victim must agree to allow the defendant to participate. I believe, however, that this final decision should rest at the discretion of the judge. Just as we want the victim to be made whole, we also want the defendant to have the opportunity to change his or her life. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Elon Zorin. I'm running for judge in the Court of Common Pleas. Cash bail is a system in place where a judge or a magistrate would set a monetary amount, which would be your bail, depending on the crime you committed. The more severe your crime, the higher the bail. For example, you could commit a crime and a magistrate would set the bail at $10,000. If you could pay that amount, that means you get out of jail. If you can't pay that amount, that means you have to stay in jail pending trial. This, in effect, criminalizes poverty. One's financial status really shouldn't be the determining factor to determine if they stay in or out of jail pending trial. With respect to the use of specialty courts and restorative justice, I'm in full support of any practice that offers reasonable alternatives to incarceration such as these. As a prosecutor for the past 22 years, I know firsthand that jail is not the answer for all criminal offenses. The overwhelming majority of individuals who commit criminal offenses do so as a result of an addiction and or mental health issues. Specialty courts like drug court and mental health court are designed to address the underlying problem. They're not just putting a band-aid on it by putting somebody in jail. They actually attempt to target the problem so the individual does not reoffend. With respect to restorative justice, as the deputy district attorney in charge of our violent crimes and firearms unit, I see the impact violent crimes have on victims, defendants, and the communities as a whole. If we really want to reform our criminal justice system, we need to invest in solutions that focus on rehabilitation, and restorative justice is a step in that direction.